Silvia!
Ja?
Are you aware there's no toothbrush in this house and your daughter hasn't brushed her teeth this morning?
Yeah, I am aware. I actually used the last one.
Mm-hmm, really?
Yes.
And were you able to replace it?
No, I thought you were going to get another one.
Excuse me?
Excuse you?
What is wrong with you removing just 1,000 naira from your money and buying toothpaste for your family?
From my own money?
What is wrong with you spending your money? This job that you have, you and I worked hard together to get this job. I encourage you to get this job. Now the money that is coming from this same job, you can't even spend it on your own daughter.
Elliot, my money is my own money. Your money is our money. And I will decide on how to spend my money, where to spend my money, and who to spend my money on, because it's my money and I worked for it. Gosh!
Sylvia! Sylvia, I'm just talking to you! Sylvia!
Then I brought the light, and then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings to
Daddy.
How are you, my darling?
Hi, Daddy.
Welcome home.
Yeah, thank you, baby. How are you?
I'm good. How's your day at work?
My day was quite, you know, hectic, but of course, amazing. And you, how was your day?
My day was good.
So, darling, I have amazing news for you.
Oh, okay. Yes.
Yeah, so apparently there seems to be a job vacancy in my office.
Okay, so how is that amazing?
So here's the thing. Today was an interview day. There were so many applicants. And it turned out that it's either they were not qualified enough or not brilliant enough. So none of the applicants were accepted. And then I took a step to investigate what they were looking for. And I realized my superiors were scouting for someone who could perfectly handle the job of a business administrative manager. And babe, you are the one for that job.
Hey, I've not practiced in a while, even if I have to do the job. It has to be a lesser position.
No, babe. Listen, you are my wife, okay? I'm very much aware of your capabilities. This is something that you can handle. All you have to do is just give it a try. I mean, what do we have to lose? Just say yes. Come on, darling.
Okay.
That's my girl. So let me go change her. I'll join you guys shortly, right? Oh, thank you, love. For you to climb up so high, I gave you wings so you
could soar. Babe. It says all of it. We can go through. I think we're on to a good start. Let's see.
Oh, this is amazing.
What?
Going through your CV and seeing our survey, it just dawned on me that our company has a policy for not employing staff that are relatives.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah.
So, what do we do now?
I don't know, I need to think of something.
That's serious.
Yeah, I think I have an idea. Here's what you are going to do. Babe, you might not like the sound of this, but what if you change the surname that you currently use, I mean our name, to your former surname, your father's name?
Babe.
That's the only way this can go. If not, you won't get this job.
Why can't we just come out in the open, you talk to your boss about it? I mean, he might want to be of help.
Come out in the open. That's not going to work. The company has a standing policy that relatives cannot coexist in the same organization.
What protocols, policies can be broken?
My darling, this particular protocol can't be broken. Believe you me, I have worked in this office for some years now. I mean, we once had a case of two colleagues falling in love and getting married. Our company had to give them an ultimatum to choose who gets retained and who gets sacked.
Wow, that's serious.
Exactly my point. So we're left with no choice but to change your son.
Okay, what if we get caught afterwards? What if they find out?
No one's going to find out. I don't make friends in the office. None of our colleagues live in our neighborhood or know you and I as a couple. So as long as you and I maintain a positive working relationship at work and at home, where our loving husband and wife, we're good to go.
I mean, we could give it a try. There's no harm in trying.
But all the same, your CV is amazing. I always knew you had so much brain.
Please, after all that work and work, it's all in vain, obviously. It's fine. Then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings so you could soar. But I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together, we should be working as one. Yes, we should help each other. And carry burdens as one. We should be working as one. Da 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 da.
Yes, come in.
Good day, sir.
Good day. Who are you and how may I help you, please?
I'm Sylvia Gautam, sir. I am here to apply for the position of a business admin manager in your company.
Oh, please sit.
Thank you, sir.
So, what are your qualifications?
I'm a master's degree holder in business administration and strategy.
Impressive. Any experience?
I have 6 years experience in marketing strategy and 3 years in business administration. And sir, apart from my series of experience, I have a special skill in human management and business entrenchment. So these are more is what I have to offer to your company.
Impressive. When can you start?
Sir?
Yes. Without doubt, you have what we needed. I do not want to prolong this interview.
Oh my God.
Yes. At the exit of the last floor, the last office by your right, is the office of the HR. Please stop by and get your employment letter.
Oh my God. Thank you so much, sir. And I promise I will not relent in whatever I have to do to make this company move forward. I won't disappoint you. Thank you so much.
Your potential salary will be sent to your mail before the end of work today.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. I appreciate this. I won't let you down. God bless you, sir.
Wow. What a beautiful girl.
Hello, babe.
What's up? What's up, babe? Tell me, how did it go? Have you seen the MD?
Yes. I got the job.
Yes, yes, yes. I knew it. I knew you were going to get this job. So where are you now?
I'm heading out now. I'm on my way out.
I just took a walk to the shop near the office just to get some water. Babe, you know what? I don't want people seeing us together, okay? I don't want things to mess up for two of us, all right?
It's okay, babe. I'll see you at home then.
Okay, no problem. I love you.
I love you more.
Saw a light. Yes. And then I brought you.
I'm the Kayode Oseni Street. I'm just parked at the junction. Madam, okay, you will see one silver Toyota Camry car is on the road. Yes. Just come out here and pick me, please. I can't find my way down there. Oh yeah, please be fast. I'll just wait inside the car. All right, thank you.
They be lipstick, they be lala. They be coco me sexy.
Isaac. Isaac, you and Haley now fight us. What's the happen?
I'm a better person than the Haley now. You're looking so good.
Thank you.
What do you do for my area now?
You stay around here.
You're not my area now. I've been here for like 4 years.
Oh my God. Yes, no. I came to see my tailor.
Oh, your tailor?
Yes.
Is it my mother?
You know her?
Yes, now. She lives down the street.
No wonder she said I should just wait here. Oh, how have you been?
I'm good. So you didn't come my area where we're like this?
No, not really. You know, most times she comes to the house to pick the clothes and then measure me. But today I want to get to her office. I want to see where she works.
Oh, okay. Yes. Now we don't in my area now. I don't know my house now.
Oh, no, it's okay. Maybe next time. Let me just wait for her next a little.
Okay,
yeah.
No problem now. I still don't know my house now. Make I enter church first.
You they go church?
Yeah. My God.
Isaac.
Baby.
It's good to see you again. Go, no. Don't do this. Don't do this. Let me just wait for her while she comes out and pick me. All right, darling.
Yeah, so today we are celebrating my baby.
Babe.
Yes, what are you talking about? You landed the job, darling.
Yes, babe. Thanks to you.
Thanks to you, too. You never disappoint. Oh. So, there you go.
Thank you. Babe, it's okay.
Okay.
I have work tomorrow, remember?
That's true. Don't worry, we can't finish it. I'll finish it. Yeah, so cheers to a good beginning.
And to a profitable one. Like that. Cheers, babe. And thanks to you for making this happen. I'm already thinking, what am I going to wear to work tomorrow?
No, thanks to you, darling. You are a smart one. I knew you were going to nail this. You know, I kept dreaming of today. And now, here we are.
Yes, babe. And you made it happen.
If you say so, we made it happen, right?
I can't believe I'll be going back to work after a long while. Like, this is really happening.
That's true. And, you know, I think about the box, you know, the money you'll be making. Yeah, I mean, these are the things that we need to look
very
at.
Very important.
Very, very important.
Thank you, babe. I'm really, really excited. I can't wait.
Yeah.
And then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings so you could soar. But I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together.
Babe.
What do you think about this over this as a first day at work outfit? This is a long pants. Really long.
I think it's perfect.
How about this one? This one. Cut this right. What do you think?
Babe, listen. You are an extremely gorgeous woman. And very well endowed. So every single dress that you put on that body of yours sits perfectly well.
Thank you, but that's not actually the response I was expecting. But it's fine. Thinking this one.
Babe, don't tell me you're going to spend the rest of the night rehearsing outfits for tomorrow and end up being late for work. Hey. That will be a very, very terrible, bad impression. Think about that.
Wait, are you trying to make sure that I don't go to work making an impression? I have to look the part.
I know. I'm not trying. I'm just saying, think about time too, because, you know.
It's fine. I'll just round up on this one. Oh my God.
What's the problem?
I forgot to sort out my hair, shoe, bags. Come on.
Oh my God. You sure want to get late to work?
No, I'm just trying to look the part. It's my first day at work.
Okay.
I need to look the part. Let me sort it out with me. Don't worry, I won't be long.
Knock yourself out.
I am loving this black shoe. Babe, what do you think? This one.
I don't know. I don't know what you think. Everything is good, okay? Anything you wear is beautiful. I saw a light, and then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings so you could soar, but I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together, we should be working as one. Yes, we should help each other and carry burdens as one. We should be working as one. Da, 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 da. Darling, you know that I can't drop you in the office, right? Da, da, da,
I know it's fine. Just drop me off at the junction.
But don't you think that won't be too conspicuous? I mean, people might just see you hop off the car. Why don't I drop you at the estate gate?
It's okay. It's fine. Oh my God, babe. Oh, God. I totally forgot we didn't make any provision for Maya's welfare.
Oh my God, what a mistake. So what do we do now?
I don't know, and I don't get off work till like 5. And Maya's lesson stops for 4. And you don't get home till 6:30.
Yes, I know, but we can't allow this kind of mistake to affect your work.
Maybe I should just go tell the MD, talk to him.
No. It's too early to be making excuses at work.
Can you please call Uju to come stay with her till we get a nanny?
Yes, I can do that. And that's a nice idea, but what about today?
I'll just try and do anything to finish early. Like, we don't have a choice.
Oh, Dad, don't worry about me. I'm a big girl.
I see. Thanks for reminding us.
Alright, let's go.
Oh my God, what were we thinking? It just skipped off my head.
It happens.
Hey, girlfriend. I'm good. How are you? And how is my little angel and hubby? Yeah, I'm in town. I just got in this morning. Yeah. What? Babe, you just got a job. That's not true. Where? When? You have assumed office already. That was so quick. Babe, okay, just send me your address immediately. Send me the address. I'll come see you. I want to come and see with my own eyes. Hey, wow. I'm so happy for you. That was so fast. Don't worry, I'll come. Okay, I might not come today, but I'll definitely come. Maybe tomorrow. Hey, babe, I'm so happy for you. All right, darling. I miss you too. All right, baby. See you soon, okay? Yeah, take care of yourself. Oh, all right, darling. Bye, bye. See you later.
Oh. Hello, Sylvia.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm very well, sir. Please sit.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Well, I came to officially welcome you to DVN International.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. I hope you like your new office.
I do. It's very convenient. I like it.
And I hope your AC is working perfectly.
Yes, it is. It's perfect.
Well, in case you notice any irregularities, do not hesitate to let me know, okay?
I would, sir. I wouldn't hesitate to let you know.
Sylvia? I look forward to having an amazing work experience with you.
Same here, sir.
I'll just take my leave.
Okay, sir.
See you around. Nice. See you around.
Yeah, you the fuck up.
How? I don't understand.
How can you allow your wife get a job that she earns far more than you?
You know, bro, sometimes I really don't understand you. You sound so weird most of the time. I mean, what's wrong with that?
It's the reality, bro. How can a woman earns more than her husband? Now, see, finish, they knock your door, so...
Hey, listen, my wife okay? is not like that, okay? So forget about see, finish. My wife is amazing, all right? So we're good. Yeah, we're good.
Problem. You go soon come give me situation report. We there.
No, Lily, no, when the time comes, I'll give you situation report. Okay. What are you there for? Are you not my guy? Yeah?
Well, meanwhile,
before we waste much of our time, there's something I really want to talk to you about.
Okay.
I need a very small favor from you. I was wondering if you could babysit Maya till evening. I promise when I come back from work, I'll come pick her back. Please.
Elliot, babysit how?
We've not been able to get her a maid.
Bro, you see what I'm talking about? Eh? You will just leave your wife for the housewife when she be old. Now, okay.
Listen to me, bro. No man in his right senses will do that to a woman in this modern day and time. Things are different now. Things have changed. Moreover, the bills are outrageous and I cannot just sweep my wife's career under the rug simply because she is my wife.
Well, you're right. You know, she just started the job and she's going to earn more than you. Bro, I'm worried for you.
No worry. You don't need to be worried. I promise you everything will just be fine, okay? So back to the Maya situation. I was on my way to her school to pick her up, and I want to drop her at yours. Is that something that we can do?
It's fine now. She's my daughter now. Why not? Why not?
What can I do without you, bro?
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All right. Hold on a minute.
Okay.
Hello. Wow.
Thank you.
Yeah, the house is accessible. Make yourself comfortable till I come back.
Okay, brother. Brother, but I'm hungry.
I think there's something in the fridge that you can microwave and eat.
Brother, like I am very hungry. That one is a long process. I did not even take anything before leaving Benin. Besides, I took the nearest bus immediately you called and told me about Maya's birthday.
Okay, so what would you have me do?
You should give us money to get some other thing. I can't wait for a frozen food to be resolved.
Alright, fine. Let's see what I have here. Okay, there you go. I hope this money will go.
Thank you. So when are you coming back?
I'll be coming back late, but madam will come back earlier, alright?
Okay. See you then.
Bye.
Alright, bye.
God. Babe, I mean, this is amazing.
I know, right?
Honestly, I thought you were joking. That was why I decided to come and see with my own eyes.
All hail the daughter of a doubting Thomas.
Yeah, I know. But seriously, how are you guys coping?
Babe, it is hard.
Oh, I can imagine. Seriously.
Yeah.
But I mean, I have to commend your husband. He's a strong man. Imagine him working in the same firm with his wife as a junior staff.
Not just a junior staff, a driver.
Yeah, that's true. How is he handling all of that?
Well, Elliot is fine. He's handling it well. Like I told you, all of this was his idea. But I thank God for the kind of heart he has. God.
He honestly does have a good heart.
Yeah, he does.
Babe, please don't disappoint him, I beg.
Not on this earth. How can I?
Yeah, no. I trust you. I trust you. Mom, honestly, this is your office, fine.
It's giving, and right?
And it's giving. Dressing and all of that. Yes, you know. Honestly, this is beautiful. Wow. Yeah, when the boss. Happening. Yeah.
Hello, love. Yeah, I'm on my way to Maya School, actually. I just thought that since you're having a meeting very soon, I can quickly go there and attend to their PTA meeting. You're welcome, love. It's nothing. What about the MD? Is he there? Okay, please, when you guys are done with the meeting, inform me so I can come back quickly. I don't want them to notice my absence. Okay, love. I love you. Mwah. Yes, we should help each other
together and carry burdens as one. I just got a call from the Ministry of Education concerning a proposal to supply a writing material for the forthcoming WAEC GCE.
Oh, sir. That is a good news. Wonderful.
That's a nice
it's one. A big win for the company.
Yeah. But at the second thought, I'm a bit afraid. There's a problem here.
So what could that be?
You know, your last proposal was rejected by the state government. And I wouldn't want such to repeat itself again.
Sir, I will do my best to have a better and viable proposal this time, sir.
Okay, if I can get on it, I would like to start it before the end of today.
Oh, okay, sir. So one more time, congratulations, sir.
Congratulations.
It's a big win for the company, sir.
It's all right, yeah.
All right, sir.
See you later.
Wow.
I think you're so funny, I think
so. Babe, why did you like this now? You are so funny. Is that why you are not serious with me?
You're funny. You think he's serious or what?
I don't, babe, how many times I go tell you, say, Angel Michael, tell me for dreams, say, now you be my wife.
Angel Michael?
No, yeah,
don't be only Angel Michael. What of Angel Gabriel? You just want to crack my ribs today.
See, Debbie, let's be serious, all right? I'm in love with you now. I'm so in love with you.
You're serious?
I don't use all the lingua franca in my mouth. Tell you how I feel. How be won't make a call Angel Michael, can't tell you. Eh?
Are you serious?
Hey, say you didn't want me. I'm serious now. I'm in love with you. I'm so in love with you. I'm crazy about you. Oh, give me a chance.
Isaac, you're really serious.
Yeah, I'm serious now. Give me a chance.
I don't believe this. If you and I are in the house, you practically cracked me all of my ribs into your jokes.
Babe. Listen, I'm in love with you.
Okay.
Give me a chance now. Why did you like this? You're not just being serious. Oh, God.
You know, you always make me laugh. Anyway, it's a good thing, though.
It's a good thing, though. Mm-hmm. Is that a yes?
No, I did not say that. So let's just see how it goes.
No problem, it's fine, it's fine.
For you to climb up so high, I gave you wings so you could soar. But I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together.
No, I just keep it inside. Sylvia?
Sir.
How are you going home?
I ordered for a ride.
Oh, no, come on, you can join me. My driver will drop you off.
No, thank you, sir. I'll rather
Sylvia,
wait.
Sylvia, I insist.
Sir, I appreciate your kind gesture, but I'd rather wait for my ride. It's almost there.
Okay. See you tomorrow.
Okay, sir. Have a nice one.
Yeah. Sylvia, are you sure you can do this alone?
Yes, sir.
Or should I pair you with the head of the marketing department to do it together?
No, sir. I would want to do my own thing. And you can call for a conference meeting or a screening.
So that's you saying you work better alone, right?
Kind of. I totally oblige to the rules. I cannot displace teamwork, but I really would want to put down my creativity. And you can screen it.
Will you have until tomorrow?
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. See you tomorrow. See you around.
Mr. Buster, you're still here. Mr. Buster, you're still here?
Yes, I'm here.
What's the problem, guy?
See, you understand that there are levels and degrees to insult, right?
Yeah. What's the problem this time?
Time D is getting on my nerves, though. That man is trying me, he's tempting me.
What about him? What has he done this time?
Why are you sounding like you are not in the meeting? Eh?
Sincerely speaking, I don't know what you're talking about.
Who's the marketing manager of this company?
You, of course.
Good. Whose business is it to prepare proposals and deals for this company?
You or the business admin manager?
No. It is in my jurisdiction to prepare proposals and deals for this company. However, in my absence, the admin manager can come in but it also has to be with my consent.
Actually, but I thought both of you, you know.
Come on, what are you saying? That recommendation and applause that you saw, did it look like a corporate one?
Guy, you need to calm down. If you have any issues over this, please try and see the MD. You know, let him see reason that you're not happy.
No. I'm not going to discuss this with the MD. He should continue. He should just keep doing what he likes. But anytime he comes to me that I should do proposal or deals for this company, I will remind him that in the first place, he was the person that moved my job description to Sylvia.
Guy, you really have to calm down now. Please. You need to calm down, please.
Sylvia?
Sir.
Wow. That was a wonderful presentation.
Thank you, sir.
I never knew you have so much upstairs. I must confess, you look too humble for what you present.
Thanks for the compliment, sir.
You're welcome. You know what? You just saved my neck, and I'd like to appreciate you with lunch. What do you say?
I don't do lunch, sir.
How ethical you must be.
It's just a phobia.
Okay, so can we do a drink? And so we can have time to talk about the contract further.
Why can't we do that in the office?
Come on, Sylvia. Stop being too official. Sometimes you just need to unwind. Plus, they say all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
It's fine, sir. It's okay.
So, shall we?
Let me get my bag. I'll join you in a bit.
All right.
I saw a light, and then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings so you could soar, but I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together, we should be working as one.
We should be working as one.
Yes, we should help each other.
We should be together.
And carry burdens as one.
We should be working as one.
Da 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 da.
Bonjour, baby. How are you now?
I'm fine.
So you have been in town and you didn't bother to come and check up?
Yes, I've been busy, you know.
Busy?
Yes.
Not be house with the day.
No, I've been busy. I've been doing one or two stuff. You should know now.
This girl. Okay. Why are you?
Come inside, let me give you one or two stuff.
No.
Even if it's water.
No. I have somewhere to go.
All right.
Maybe next time, okay?
Okay.
Take care of yourself, eh?
Bye.
Who's your baby?
Okay, Okay, so baby, I was thinking. Baby, why are you looking at me like that?
Ah, you know, see, I thank God every day. Ah, baby, you're so fine.
Oh my God, this man.
See, baby, now. See, full package now. Everything complete. Ah! See, God, take time, design you.
You have started. You have started, right? Why do you always want
to? you have a gorgeous smile.
Any day I meet your mom, I'm going to ask her the day she gave birth to you. Because I hear that the people they give birth to on Sundays are always very humorous and funny. And you, I'm very sure they gave birth to you on Sunday because you always make me laugh and laugh and laugh in this house.
It can't be like say they use sand cover my eye. I don't really see the thing where. Now they see. Ah! Baby, you're so beautiful. See now. Full option, everything. Baby. You're so fine, my queen.
Yeah, right. You're queen.
You're my cocoa, my sexy.
Good job.
My chocomilo.
You're making me shy.
My fresh queen.
Not to you, mommy. Let me what I'm doing, please. Wait. Let me fold this your clothes now.
My baby.
Babe, I'm coming.
My baby.
And then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder. For you to climb up so high, I gave you wings to you.
Ojo, baby.
Hi!
You sabi cook, this food's sweet.
Ah, stop pulling my legs, I beg. Anyway, thank you. Let me go to the kitchen and clean up everything. I'll be right back, okay?
Yeah, okay. Fine.
Oh, that's my phone.
Okay.
Hello, wifey. I am fine. And how is work? Yes. I'm done cleaning up everything. You're welcome. That's why I'm here for you. Oh, not yet. So, let me quickly take my bed, then I'll go pick her up from school. All right, you're welcome. Bye. Take care.
Is that how she calls you and gives instruction like every day, like a maid?
Like a maid? I don't understand.
What's your response? It's like you are giving situation report.
Oh, yes. I was actually giving situation reports. You know, that's how she tried to balance her work with her wifey duties. It's nothing, you know.
Wifely duties. By calling you her sister-in-law and giving instructions like a maid. See, you and your brother are just rubbishing yourself for that woman. I know very soon now she will take advantage of you.
Anyway, I don't know. But I'm cool with that.
Yeah, cool. You will soon know a woman. The one that they see for you. Girl.
Welcome.
Yes, I'm back.
Don't tell me you're still angry.
Why won't I be angry? My wife humps at the back of a lunch date. And you think I should be happy about that?
Okay, I'm sorry.
Really? So tell me, what exactly are you sorry about? About the fact that you sat so close to him and gave him the leverage to undress you with his eyes? Or the actual lunch date itself?
Babe, I already told you it wasn't a lunch date. He just wanted us to talk about the contract.
Yes, a contract. And tell me how confidential this contract is that it couldn't be discussed about in a work environment.
He insisted.
Really? And as somebody's wife that you are, you did not deem it fit to hesitate, not even for a second.
Now you're taking this too far, okay? You're taking it too far.
That's all you have to say, right? You're taking it too far.
What else do you want me to say? No, tell me, what else do you want me to say? I've explained the situation to you. I've told you exactly what happened, but you seem not to understand. You're getting angry and saying all what you're saying. What else do you want me to say?
You know what? Going forward, feel free to have more contract dates with him, okay? If that's what you want. Carry on. That's what you want. Go on. I'll be watching. I'll be fine. We will be fine.
And you're taking this thing too serious. You're taking it too far. It's nothing. I've told you it's not a... It wasn't a date. Nothing serious. Gosh.
No problem. I'm ready. And then I brought you for you to climb up so
high. Mr. Buster, good morning. Mr. Buster.
Yes, what is it?
I was wondering if I could get letterhead from your office.
Am I in charge of letterheads? Am I the right person to ask for letterhead?
I know you're not, but I was just thinking...
Please, I don't have time for this nonsense.
Sir, this is a perfect way to start the week, honestly.
You're right. That reminds me, we will be going to the Ministry of Education next week together.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
And you will speak more on the product we have proposed to supply. So, get all the necessary information ready.
I will, sir. I will.
Plus, the chairman has instructed that I increase your pay.
Really?
Yes.
Oh my God, thank you so much, sir. I am excited.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Expect a salary of 350,000 naira in the next 30 minutes.
Thank you.
Your accountant is on it already.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome.
This.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
So, yeah?
Sir.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
See you around.
Darling.
The chairman is such a generous man. Some other person might not have given what he did a thought.
You know, they have noticed your potential. And they know that if they avail you the necessary opportunity, you will move the company to greater heights.
And I will put in more efforts. In fact, I will do everything I can to make sure the company moves forward.
I trust you, my love. And congratulations to you.
Congratulations to us, babe. Thanks for all you do.
Thanks. Babe, I'm your husband and also your life partner. It's my responsibility to cater for us, to support you.
I know, babe, but thanks all the same.
All right, I accept it. So tell me, darling, how do you intend to rock your virgin salary?
It's still chilling in my account.
Chilling?
Mm. And you know what that means?
Mm-hmm.
I love to see my money green in my account. It makes me happy and fulfilled.
Yeah, I know. You like the green lights. But you know, you can still spoil us a little bit. You know, take us out, buy some drinks, do some karaoke, have some mild fun.
Of course we can do that, but bills on you. So take your eyes off my money. If my money is entering your eye,
close
it. Babe.
Yeah, of course.
It enter your eye. Close them.
Okay. Okay, no problem. Bills on me. It's fine. And then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder. For you to climb up.
So.
What are you up to?
Reading novel.
Okay. So, I'm ready to eat now. Can you get me something to eat?
Brother, there is no food in this house.
What do you mean? There's nothing to eat in this house?
Yeah. Auntie did not buy the list of the food item I sent to her earlier.
Oh. Well, maybe she forgot. But did you inform her that there's absolutely nothing in the house?
I did, and she asked me to prepare noodles for Maya, which I did. So that was what she ate this night before sleeping.
Well, at least Maya has had some. So, you're saying there's nothing for me to eat right now?
But there's nothing. There is nothing at all.
I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings so you could soar. But I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together,
are you aware of this?
We should be working as one.
You just said so.
So, are we eating out or something?
I mean, if that's what you want, why not?
What kind of silly response is that?
You can see I'm busy. I'm working.
Busy doing what? Busy working on what exactly, that I have to starve tonight?
I didn't say you have to starve. You can get yourself something to eat.
Really? So tell me, why didn't you pay attention to the list of foodstuff that she sent to you?
But I sent it to you and you said nothing.
Meaning what?
Meaning that your silence is the reason we don't have anything to eat.
But for crying out loud, I was driving when you forwarded them to me. There was no way I could read them when I was on wheels. And by the way, why did you even send it to me in the first place?
So you can send Uju money to buy the things that we need.
You could have as well just given her money to buy them.
How?
Your salary, of course.
Which salary?
Oh, babe, come on, your salary that was paid to you 3 days ago.
Likewise you.
Really? So, we're actually doing this, right?
Babe, please. I'm busy. I have a presentation to get ready. I don't need to be distracted. This is serious.
Yes, we should help each other and carry burdens as one.
We should be working as one.
Da 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 da.
Yes, please make a list of what we need in the house, just like you did before. But this time around, add the exact amount needed to it.
Okay.
Everything.
Right. Oh, well, you actually saw me going out, didn't you? This is for you.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. So you were actually very hungry, weren't you?
Elliot, is your plan to get me upset so I don't eat this food? I am so finishing this food.
This is the list of items we need to replace in the house.
Give it to your brother.
And why does she have to give me the list?
So you know the exact amount of what we need to buy to restock the house.
And when I know the exact amount, what will happen?
You'll give her money for it.
Is there a problem with you giving her money to buy these things?
You're the man of the house. You are supposed to make provision for whatever we need in this house.
But I've been doing that all this while, isn't it? I have been carrying the responsibility all this while. Babe, you just got your first salary. Is there a problem with you picking up the little bills in this house?
It's not my responsibility. I will do it. It's not by force. You don't have to force me. I can only do it if it's needed. You're the man of the house, so you pay the bills. And you still didn't take the list. Ha. That means we'll starve. or we'll keep buying takeouts.
I saw a light.
Please get me a spoon. Let me eat this food. Hurry up.
Then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings so you could soar. But I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together.
Wifey, please, can I take a little minute of your time?
Okay. What is it?
I know what I'm about to say now might not sound right, but please, I don't want you to be angry.
I'm all ears. Go ahead.
It's about what happened between you and my brother last night, about the financial support of a thing.
Can you just go straight to the point?
Wifey, I felt like you have a wrong impression about the whole thing. And Wifey, you know that you aim more than your husband, and I felt that it's wicked of you refusing to assist him in some bills in the house. You are his wife and you're meant to assist him.
Oh, wow. Marriage counselor of Jew. Marriage counselor of the universe. I can see you. Wow. Really?
I think what you're doing is wrong.
Look, would you please, and I beg in God's name, when you get married and you stay married at least for 5 good years, then you can come back and give me advice on my marriage, okay?
But I'm an adult, I...
How are you?
Good.
Hey, what is it? Why did you ask me to meet you up here urgently? What happened?
Please, please. If you can do, just say no. I don't want it to cause issue between us, alright?
Babe, what happened? What is it?
Babe.
Why did you say what happened?
I need a loan.
A loan?
Yeah.
What do you need a loan for?
My rent is due, and my landlord is on my neck. The heat is too much. I just need to...
Maybe it's fine, it's fine. How much is it? How much is the money?
It's 600K, babe.
Just 600K?
Yeah, you know, business is slow, but I'm going to pay back, all right?
Babe, it's fine, it's fine. You don't need to pay back. I'll give you the money.
Really?
Yes.
Come on, baby, listen. Leave it as a loan, all
babe,
right? I'm
going to
pay
now.
Back.
Just stop. How much is 600K? Why can't I assist? It's your rent, right?
Are you sure?
Yes. I mean, I can give you the money. It's your rent and I can assist you.
Baby, are you sure?
Babe, can you just
oh
stop?
My God. Thank you, baby.
Oh, come on. Is it
oh,
because
thank
of 600K?
You.
You're acting like there's something serious that went on. And I was so panicked and like the way I drove down here thinking something went wrong.
Oh, baby, I'm sorry. I couldn't sleep. That man just called me.
And you couldn't give him some, you know, funny joke. Come in.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
The MD requests for a present at the boardroom.
Do you have an idea why he wants to see me?
Not sure, ma'am. But I think the representative from S&J Holdings are here for the meeting.
Really?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh my God, it's 11 a.m. Please get me those files. I have to type out.
Okay,
hurry up, please. Hurry up. Go get them, please. Oh my God.
Hold on. Bros Isaac.
Hey, Joe, how are you?
I'm fine.
Is your brother in?
No, he's not in.
Yeah.
Well,
I told him I'm coming now.
Oh, yes. Yes, he waited for you, but his boss asked him to come and Maya was running late for school, so he had to go.
Oh, okay, let me call him.
All right.
He's not picking up. I think he's driving. I'll text him on WhatsApp now.
Why are you looking at me like that?
You You know, I like mind my business, right? But this whole thing is really pissing me off.
What is it?
Is it that your brother's wife doesn't do any house chores before she goes to work again? Look everywhere. You are the one.
Why are you asking?
From all indications, you are the one running this house. Are you enslaving yourself with your brother's wife? Yes, because at least you should do some house chores before she goes to work.
Okay. Thank you very much. I know what I'll be doing, okay?
You better try and fix things for yourself. Don't enslave yourself with your brother's wife. I'm leaving, eh?
All right, thank you.
Take care of yourself, okay?
You too. Don't have a nice day.
All right, you too.
Guy, your job is at risk. You are at the verge of listening to that lady.
Uchi, you're very correct. But as it stands, there's nothing I can do about it.
Really? Why did you say so?
It's not obvious. That office was specially created to backbench me. So with time, they can put me aside.
No wonder they've been sidelining you in so many deals. And so many decision making in the office, you'll always not be there.
I won't let them mess me up. I'll tender my resignation later and walk away. This humiliation is becoming too much.
No, don't do that. Don't throw in the blow yet. I think what you should do is try and see things with the MD. Discuss with him. He might see from a different perspective.
You think I should talk to him about this?
I really do think so.
Anyways, I'll do exactly as you have said.
No problem.
Thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome. Ooh. All right.
See you later.
Why is she calling me? Hello? Hello, ma. Good afternoon. Hello, Mrs. Grace. Oh my God, is it today? I'm sorry, ma. I am going to send your representative right away. Yes, I will. I'm sorry about that. What do I do now? Okay, since the MD is here for the meeting, Elliot should have time to go attend to her.
Nothing will make me to pick this call. I'm sure she's calling to give me one or two instructions in this house like a maid that she employed. Idiot.
Sylvia?
Sir.
We're waiting for you.
Please give me a minute, sir.
Make it a second.
Okay, sir.
Brought you to the light.
Sylvia, what were you doing going out on a date with the MD?
It wasn't a date.
Good, really? Then tell me what it was then.
Then don't do this, okay? Don't. Not here.
Why would you tell me when and where to talk to you? We're still married.
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead and shout. Get a microphone and announce your vexation to the whole office. Shout, go ahead.
You know what? We are not done with this conversation.
Climb up so high, I gave you wings so you could soar. But I don't know what has come over you.
We have the deal, so we take 75%.
Sylvia, over to you.
Sir, you have the deal, but we have what it takes to bring this deal into maturation. We have the right contacts, logistics, and mobility. So we're bringing more to the table.
What are you proposing?
We get 80% of the deal and you go with 20%.
50-50 will be fair.
That will work, sir, because yeah, it's a deal, but we will make it come alive.
What is your best bet for this?
I will say 70-30, that's a fair deal.
Theo, this is not what I expected. It's not fair. It's not fair you're taking the legacy of a deal we brought you people into.
Well, dear friend, like she said, we are bringing more to the table. You can walk away with your deal if it doesn't please you.
All right. Deal.
We have a deal.
Shall we do?
Is your MOU ready?
I want to talk to you about some recent developments in the company that I am not very pleased with.
Alright, go ahead.
So you changed my job description without informing me.
How do you mean?
So I'm not being informed about the company's business use and business execution as it used to be.
Well, that's because someone else is doing your job for you.
Don't you think that is wrong, sir? At least I should be informed or carried along.
Mr. Boster, how many deals have you pulled in this company successfully?
I pulled the Cocoa deal and...
Mr. Boster, you should be grateful that someone else is doing your job and her job efficiently. You should have been sacked by now, but because of your years of hard labor and dedication to this company, we decided to have you handle the marketing department. Because the last jobs you pulled led this company into a huge debt of 15 million naira.
But sir,
I did not bring that up for dialogue. I was only pointing out your flaws and make you see reasons why your job description has been restricted. I'm done with this conversation. Have a nice day.
Man, that man has finally made it clear that you're no longer relevant to this company.
So, what do I do now?
Guy, you have to act fast before she finally takes your place in this company.
Come on, she already has it. I'll just tender my resignation and move on.
Man, don't do that, man. Don't give up just yet. Man, you have to fight. Develop your skills. Go online. Do something. Bring in clients. Guy, you have to be competitive with her.
I think you have a point.
I'm damn sure I have a point. Man, wake up. Do something. Put her in her place. I'm bitter to again.
Oh. Thank you so much for this, man. I really appreciate
it. Man, I got your back, man. up your game.
Thank you.
Bro, you're welcome.
Celia, you know, I didn't know you have such a wonderful and strong negotiating skills.
Thank you, sir. I do my best to carry out my duty to the expectations of the company.
And you have done more than expected.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. So I just want to ask you, can we do dinner together? Please.
Sir, I'm sorry, I can't do dinner with you.
Oh, come on, Celia. It's just for us to celebrate this huge success. It's a big one.
I'm sorry, sir, I can't.
It's just dinner. Just dinner. Please.
Okay, fine. Just for 20 minutes. After work.
Okay, 20 minutes it is.
Okay, sir.
No, 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 Sylvia, don't tell me that. This is highly intolerable. You are quitting that job.
I can't quit my job.
Oh, yes, you will.
Babe, I've told you all of that is just nothing. It's harmless outings.
Harmless outings, you call them. When a man is wooing you and touching your body and you still call it harmless outings? What do you even have to say to that?
Babe, he will stop. He will stop.
Stop? How can a man ever stop? Someone who keeps pouring out his emotions to you. For crying out loud, you give him the leverage. I mean, you hop into his vehicle at every given opportunity to go on this so-called business deal and you expect him to stop.
Babe, why are you sounding like this? You and I know I'm doing this for us.
Oh, fine. Now I am saying stop doing this for us. Do you understand? Quit this job is of no use to us, especially to me.
Really?
Yes, really.
Babe, look, I know you're upset. I totally understand how you feel. I know, but see, I promise I'm going to talk to him. I'll find a way to make him stop.
Stop going to those outings. He's using them to get closer to you.
Babe, I can't say no to him. He's my boss. I tell you, he always comes with the guise of work. I can't say no. If I say no, he might be trouble.
Oh, then let there be trouble. Let there be trouble. Just tell him no. See, listen, I don't have time for this. I don't have time for this.
If we should be together, we should be working as one.
Dad, be careful with what you say before it lands into trouble.
I've seen them in compromising situations, in compromising places. Something is definitely fishy.
Well, I don't think so. That woman looks too moral and I'm very decent to be seen with that man.
You're talking about morals. Brother, open your eyes. Open your eyes and watch closely. Something is definitely going on. Don't be deceived by looks.
Well, I can't really vouch for her or for Mr. Ackman either. You know, but from the look of things, the way both of them have been, you know, seen together, it is possible.
This is no matter of it is possible. It is happening. Okay, let me ask you. All those times that we used to close early, then the both of them will be left in this office till late night. They couldn't run things now. Even during work hours, they can just find one corner and do this thing sharp. Know what I'm talking about.
True, true. So, no wonder both of them have been spending time together. It is suspicious. It is really suspicious.
What is remaining now is to catch them. I will make sure I am the one that will catch them red-handed. I will embarrass them publicly in this office. That's those nonsense they are doing. Everybody in this company will hear. I will make sure I expose them. Shall we are in this office?
We'll see you again.
Hello, sir.
Sir, I have told you time without number. I am a married woman. I can't have anything to do with you. Make it stop.
Calm down, Sylvia. Relax. I'm not asking you to leave your husband, okay? Just a little romance to spike our relationship.
What relationship are you talking about exactly?
A work relationship. You know, we can start something special. We can win more deals together, you know? Just something cool.
I am married, and it's in my CV.
Listen, Sylvia, we are not going to make it noticeable. No one know about it, just you and I. I started feeling this way from the moment you stepped into my office. Yes, and should I tell you the truth? I did not give you this job based on your qualification. I gave you because I wanted you around, always. And
so, I'm sorry.
Oh no, it's fine. Won't take you so long. Sylvia, don't go anywhere.
I'm sorry, sir. I was trying to prepare the vehicle for your convenience.
It's all right. Yeah. Go to the bank. Paying that money into the account is waiting on that check. Be fast about it, please.
No problem, sir.
Honestly, you have to thread with caution. I mean, I don't want you to destroy your marriage in this process and then you might end up even losing this job.
I've done everything I can. I've even told him I want to return the money, that I'm not interested. He insists I keep it. That is a gift. I should keep the 5 million naira.
5 million naira?
Yes.
I bet who gives somebody, who dashes somebody 5 million naira in this our hot economy? 5 million naira?
Now I don't know how to tell my husband.
Well, babe, you need to look for a way to talk to him because eventually if this thing blows up, he might mistrust you.
How will I tell him that a man that has wooed me right in front of him gave me 5 million naira? Babe, it's really weird. And if I do that, he might think something is going on.
I mean, 5 million naira is a whole lot.
I've just decided to ignore him and let him do his thing. When he gets tired, he'll stop. I'm not ready to give in to his advances. What's he thinking? I am happily married and I love my husband so much. Nothing will make me leave my marriage. Hell no. He'll get tired.
And you think he will stop?
He will.
Well, he should stop because honestly, what's his problem? Seriously.
I saw a light. And then I brought you to the
heart. Who's there? I'm coming. Hey, guy, what's up, bro? I did cook.
What's in the apple?
I told you they fire, bro.
Chef Elliot. What's in the apple? Chef Elliot. What's in the cook? Chef Elliot.
Chef Elliot. No, maybe Chef Elliot.
No, he cook in the cook, so. Come on, are you hungry? Are you hungry?
You don't hide your ear mouth to come here, have you? You're hungry. And I hear you want chop. No problem.
See my guy, I'm hungry,
oh. Hungry, kill you, dear. Hungry.
Cook well, oh. No
anyway,
stress.
How are you, sir? What's up with you, man?
I'm good now. I say, I can go keep you company now.
No, the funny thing is, I actually needed this company because recently my head has been going gaga.
Mm.
But drop that your nonsense attitude outside.
Why did you do like that? You know, say if I see, I must talk now.
Talk the one way to save your life, because I feel like I feel show you something.
Calm down. Well, you know you cannot do without me now. Normally, I'm saying now we don't be houseboy. So you need encouragement from good friends.
Like, but you're not encouraging me, guy.
How?
As a matter of fact, you the answer to my problem.
What? Which other encouragement you need again? Oh, make I put sense for your head, make you the soccer line press me. Can't understand. Calm down.
I will stop you for you.
See my guy.
If I not stop you,
calm down. Calm down now. That's why you don't turn a house boy for house finish. My guy. Chef Lily. Chef Lee Coco. Omo, do that in fast. I'm hungry. I beg.
I became a ladder for you to climb up so high.
Yeah, have fun now. Your wife don't show up that 5 million naira finish.
Yeah, why you do like this though? Why are you always trying to make jest of me at every slight opportunity? Come on, man. Must you make fun of me every time?
Why you talk like that now? Omar, I won't borrow money. If you just talk to her, maybe she just borrow me like 100k.
How? Isaac, how? Sylvia, give you 100k. Hey, see if I don't go give you Shingbai. They play.
Oh, no good. You borrow me, I'll be one time she never dash you money.
Dash how? Siva's not giving me anything from her salary, not to talk of this one that she doesn't even mention to me.
Ha! Wait. So she never tell you about the money at all?
Nope. She didn't tell me anything.
Oh, that's your wife getting mind, though.
My wife is a mafia.
Good afternoon, Uncle Isaac.
Oh, Maya, baby. How are you?
I'm fine, Uncle.
You didn't go to school today. What happened?
She went to school, actually, but she was feeling uneasy, so she had to close early. Maya, let me go get you something to eat, huh?
No, Dad, no, I'm feeling hot.
You're hot? Come. That means the medication must be working. Bro, let me take her to the shower, okay?
I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together.
And where are you coming from?
Work, of course.
So you now work at night?
Elliot, I had a board meeting.
At this hour of the night. You know, Sylvia, you seem to have forgotten so soon that I worked in that company. And this is not obtainable.
Are you insinuating that I'm lying?
No, I'm not. I am not insinuating that you are lying. I am telling you to your face that you are lying.
Really?
Yes. And you will tell me where you are coming from.
Look, Elliot, I had a very long day. I've been sitting down for the past 7 hours trying to defend the proposal. I am tired and I need to rest.
Sylvia! You dare not walk out when I am still talking to you.
What will you do? Hit me, slap me, what will you
do? Don't you dare push me!
I am not pushing you! And whatever it is that is eating you up is your damn business!
Have you paid for Maya's school fees?
And why would I do that? Why? It's your responsibility as the man of the house to take care of the bills, pay her fees.
You earn way more than I do. I don't even work anymore. You are the one that works. You earn. Why can't you just pay for her school fees and stop this madness?
Elliot, why will I do that? You are the man of the house. The man of the house takes care of the bills, pays everything, makes provision for his daughter. You need to pay her school fees and get your eyes off my money.
Know so well that I would have done it if I could. I would never wait for her school to drive her out of class.
Oh my God. Maya was sent out of school? Elliot, you didn't pay for her school fees this time.
Well, I paid half of it when I was still working before I quit my job. I was expecting you to clear the rest of it.
Why will I clear the rest of it? Why should I do that? You are the man of the house. Should I say that over and over again? You take care of the bills. You make provisions for everything, including your daughter's school fees, and not me. Look, I don't know how you're going to do this. I don't care how you're going to do it. You have to man up to your responsibilities. Pay her school fees.
Sylvia, who are you? You know, I still can't believe that I married you.
Okay, no. You won't start with this emotional and psychological blackmail game you always do. Don't do it, not today. I had a long day, I'm not taking this. Please.
Damn it!
If we should be together, we should be working as one. If we should be together, we should be working as one.
Darling, how are you?
Fine, darling. I want to watch Cats 7.
Oh, you want to watch? Come closer. Maya, daddy. Did you brush your teeth this morning?
No, daddy, there isn't toothpaste in the house.
Are you sure?
Yes, daddy.
Did you check where your mother usually keeps the bathroom supplies?
Yes, daddy, I did.
So you are saying you went to school today without brushing your teeth?
Yes, daddy. My classmates were laughing at me.
Oh my. Sylvia! Sylvia!
Yeah?
Sylvia, are you aware there's no toothbrush in this house and your daughter hasn't brushed her teeth this morning?
Yeah, I am aware. I actually used the last one.
Mm-hmm, really?
Yes.
And were you able to replace it?
No, I thought you were going to get another one.
Excuse me?
Excuse you?
What is wrong with you removing just 1,000 naira from your money and buying toothpaste for your family?
From my own money?
What is wrong with you spending your money? This job that you have, you and I both have together to get this job. I encourage you to get this job. Now the money that is coming from this same job, you can't even spend it on your own daughter.
Elliot. My money is my own money. Your money is our money. And I will decide on how to spend my money, where to spend my money, and who to spend my money on, because it's my money and I worked for it. Gosh!
Sylvia! Sylvia, I'm just talking to you! Sylvia!
I saw a light, and then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings so you could soar. But I don't know what has come over you. Mm-hmm. If we should be together, we should be working as one. Yes, we should help each other
together
and carry burdens as one.
We should be working as one.
Da 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 da
da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da
Babe, sit up. I want to discuss something to you.
What happened?
It's about your friend. Sit up. See. Your friend, you really need to talk to her. Before she will use her hand to destroy her own marriage. Kondi Wakago Church, Hallelujah, Prayer Ministry. From there to Baba, do it for me.
Honestly, I decided to keep quiet about this thing because I don't want to interfere with anything that has to do with a husband and wife. First, we get onions, no asking they take cut out.
So let's just leave them.
Babe, onions will not cut well. It'd be like grass for food.
I know. Babe, can we just leave this issue, please? They are adults. I mean, they can sort themselves out.
Come on. Babe, please, talk to her. Elliot is going through a lot. Eh? Before depression will come kill this guy, yo. When you go here now, person don't commit suicide.
God forbid. Commit suicide? Is it that bad?
Well, listen, you really need to talk to your friend. Let her know what she's doing is wrong. Huh? What do you think?
What do I think about what?
What she's doing, I mean, that act of unwillingness to support her husband financially. It's wrong now.
Well, I think she's an adult. Everybody have their own beliefs. I'm sure she has her reasons for whatever she's doing.
What reason? Do you think it's right?
I want to
know. Do you think it's right?
Okay, fine. I don't think it's right.
So tell me. Why? Why do you think it's not right? Just tell me.
I mean, leaving the whole responsibility to a man knowing that he's not financially strong can lead him to an early grave. He could die untimely of so much responsibility.
Good. Very good. Please, baby, preach this gospel to your friend. Let her know what's up. And before this man go just die, she'll go use money to go to burial. Eh? Come on. She needs to know the truth. But do you know why I asked you these questions?
Why?
I wanted to hear your own side. I wanted to hear your view. Yeah. Make you not be like, say, the same blind person who carry on that blind person for poto poto. Both of them will come stay there. They drink poto poto. My name now. Yes. I don't want to make mistakes.
I saw a light.
Yes, who is it? Come in.
Sir.
Elliot.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. How are you? Good to see you again.
Yes, sir. I'm fine.
Oh, please sit.
Thank you, sir.
I hope you're okay.
How about that, sir? First of all, I want to apologize for the way I quit my job. And, ever since then, things have been very, very tough for me. I don't want to bore you with the details, but I'm just hoping that I can be forgiven and I can get my job back.
Elliot. Well, I would have loved to employ you back, but I employed someone else already. So sorry about that.
But sir, is there anything that you can do? I mean, I have other skills. I can do a lot of things. I can even be a janitor. I can clean. Please.
Elliot, can I ask you a question?
Yes, sir.
Why did you quit your job in the first place?
Sir, I was having domestic trouble, family challenges.
You care to share?
I was gradually losing respect as a man because I was a driver.
Was anyone harassing you or bullying you?
No, sir, no, far from it. It's just that my wife's attitude towards me was becoming unacceptable.
Oh. Well, I'm so sorry about that.
Thank you, sir.
No, it's fine. You're welcome. So sorry.
But, sir, things are really bad, to be honest, and I can really use your help.
Elliot?
Sir?
I will employ you, but not as my personal driver. You will be driving the business admin manager.
Mrs. Sylvia?
Yes, Mrs. Sylvia. So if you're okay with that, you can start work tomorrow. Our official car will be provided today. So it's up to you.
Yes, sir. I'm so grateful. Thank you very much, sir.
That's fine.
God bless you.
So you think about it, and you get back to me.
I'm fine. I'm taking the job.
All yeah. Right, then. See you tomorrow, then.
Thank you, sir. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Have a good day.
Yes, sir.
In the car. You took this job, okay? So don't complain.
So you want to sit at the back of the car while I drive you to work?
Elliot, this is official. So don't make it anything sentimental right now, okay? Drive, take me to work. Please, do your job.
For you to climb up so high, I gave you wings so you could soar. But I don't know what has come over you. If we should be together, we should be working as one. Yes, we should help each other and carry burdens as one. Da da da.
Get away till anybody want tell me. This girl don't go back. MD did not only give her an official car. MD gave her his best driver.
Eh? Man, I first sticks in a rumor about this official car of a team. But tonight has done on me. Oh man, no be joke.
See, you know get away till anybody want them. You know that driver. That driver now, MD right hand man.
Of course I don't know him. What are you telling me? This guy, this is not serious. This is a joke, man.
See, this thing is not normal. This thing is not normal, but you know what? I will get to the root of this matter. I will investigate this matter. I will look for her husband and I will expose her.
God,
I will expose them.
Don't, you are going too far. My hand no day. Work no day time. Okay. If you mess up, you don't lose your job.
If I don't do anything about it, I will still lose the job.
Okay.
So I will get to the root of this matter. This girl cannot just come here and chance everybody now.
You're on that matter, you're on your own.
So you are not willing.
But babe, why would you allow him to take such a job?
He didn't tell me. The MD said I've been assigned a new car and a driver, an official car and a driver, only for me to see my husband.
Now what for Elliot too? Well, babe, don't you think you're being too strict with him?
How do you mean?
The assistance thing. Maybe he has apologized to you and now he's thinking that he did something that you're punishing him for.
Oh, why would you say that?
Okay, well, honestly, I didn't want to involve myself in this whole thing. He called me, he talked to me about it.
The thing is, I just feel weird sharing or giving my husband my money. It's weird. He's doing well. He should continue with what he's doing. He's not doing badly.
Sylvia.
Yeah?
Sylvia, be honest with me. Is there something he did? I mean, is there something he did you're not telling me or him? There should be something, right?
Maybe he didn't do anything. Like I said, I just feel weird sharing responsibilities with a man.
How can you feel weird sharing responsibility with your husband? You're his wife. I mean, you're his better half. You should assist him where necessary. I mean, if he's lagging behind anywhere, you should be able to help him out. That's why you are his wife.
He's doing well. It's not like he's doing badly. He's trying.
But that guy is training himself to make ends meet. I mean, he got you this job so that it would be a relief for him, but obviously he's a nightmare. I mean, you don't want him to develop high blood pressure and die of cardiac arrest.
God forbid, nothing happens.
Babe, that is why you should pull yourself together and don't kill your husband. Babe, you need to change. Honestly, for him to speak to me about it, that's because it hurts him. Change. I beg.
Then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high. I gave you wings so you could soar.
Hey.
But I don't know what has come over you.
Go out. Have a good time. You know, family kind of fun. It's the weekend.
I don't have any money, so I guess it's a no.
Bills on me.
I really appreciate the invitation. But we don't have a lot of things in the house, so if you have so much money to spend, why don't you start by stocking up the house? You know, groceries, supplies, and whatnot. I think that would be a better idea.
I've done all of that already. I've even cooked soups, stews, different types, and stocked up the fridge. So we have nothing to worry about. Let's just go out and have some fun.
Babe, you did all of that?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Babe, I also want to say that I'm very sorry for being so insensitive to my role as a wife. I'm sorry for not supporting you. I'm sorry for being so rigid. I'm sorry for being very foolish. I'm sorry.
It's okay, darling. Thank you.
I love you.
I love you more.
So, where are we going to? Your favorite spot?
Yeah. You already know.
Then I brought you to the light. I became a ladder for you to climb up so high.
Where's the secretary?
Secretary went to buy something. See, Guy, do you know that those two are a couple?
Are you sure about that?
If I'm not sure, I'll not be telling you now. I have evidences. Even if I don't provide evidences, they cannot deny it.
So what are you going to do now?
What else? I'll go straight to the chairman and tell him about it now.
Ah, the chairman is not in town, man.
That's true. I'll wait for him till he gets back. You know I cannot tell the MD about this. If I tell him, he'll find a way to cover it up because of the affair he's having with her.
Come to think of it, if he's having an affair with her, the husband should know.
Of course, the husband is aware. No? See this guy? You don't know crazy things happen these days. As long as money is coming, who cares?
Man. Money talks, bullshit walks.
I'll say that again. I am very certain the husband is aware of it. But of course, it's business for him, so...
Man. But come to think of it, though, what if they are relatives? Are you really sure about this?
Well, if they are relatives, it gets more interesting. It means that their affairs don't get plenty now. Relatives are not supposed to work in the same office.
Man, Guy. Just be careful, though. You really have to be very, very careful.
See, this one you're saying is your own. Me, I'll just be calm. I'll just pretend as if everything is cool till the chairman comes back. Then I'll strike.
Strike?
I'll take them straight to the chairman.
You strike?
Uh-huh.
Man, this life is rugged, though. You better just be calm.
Oh, God, nothing will happen.
Life don't get plateau. Life don't get duplicate, though. Calm yourself down. Oh.
Pain.
What?
Pain.
How long would it take you to come? I was calling you and waiting for you and you're still delaying. Why?
I was busy. My boss is there.
Busy doing what? How long will I continue to see this with my own eyes in this office? I'm getting tired of all this.
Can you stop?
I can't stop.
Why in the workplace?
You are still my wife, for God's sake!
I am your wife, and so why are you shouting?
It's enough is enough. This has to stop, okay? I can't take this anymore. Do you know what I'm passing through, seeing all this rubbish happening in front of my very eyes?
Why are you doing this again? Why in the workplace? Don't do this.
See, listen, listen. This has to stop.
Put yourself together.
Fine, fine. I'm trying to put myself together.
You're shouting.
Then put yourself in my shoes, for God's sake.
Oh my God.
So, Elliot, what is it you said you wanted to see me?
Yes, sir. Sylvia and I are truly husband and wife.
What? Are you joking?
It's true.
Jesus Christ. Why did you tell me all this while? Elliot!
Sir, it's not entirely your fault. But as it stands now, I cannot allow my wife continue working in this firm.
Jesus Christ. She can still walk here. We'll just find a way
around. I know the rules, sir. But really, I can't leave here and leave my wife in this company. My wife and I will get a life somewhere else.
Jesus Christ. Oh, no. It's not happening. Elias, listen. It's fine. I totally understand. I will sign your resignation and plus your salary fully paid.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome. Elliot?
Sir.
I am truly sorry for everything. I really am.
Thank you.
What do you want me to say? You ended it all.
Yes. I ended it all. It was for the better. For my own sanity. And your reputation as a woman.
The deed has been done already, so what next?
Currently, you have over 10 million naira lying in your bank account. The big question is, what's your plan for it?
How do you know about my bank account balance?
Sylvia, I'm still your husband.
How do you think I saved up all that money?
I've always known about all your monetary gifts. Starting from the very first one. A check of 5 million naira that was paid into your account by me.
And you kept quiet all this while?
Yes. I just wanted to know what your plans truly were.
Elliot, I am truly sorry. I'm sorry I kept all of this away from you.
It's okay, Doc. At least now, we have something to fall back to.
Thank you for being so understanding.
Come on, darling. You're my wife. Hmm?
You're always in my wife. You're the best hobby ever.
You're the best.
If we should be together.
Mr. Atom, what is Mr. Boxer doing here? Where is Sylvia?
Sir, she resigned.
What? Resigned when?
Well, sir, she said she wants to quit working and start a business so she can have time for her family.
Man. Why don't you make her an offer? Huh?
Sir, I tried my best, but she made up her mind already.
Can I get her contact?
Yes, sir, I will. I'll just...
Sir, I have something to say, sir.
What is it?
Elliot and Silva, husband and wife, they are married.
Who is Elliot?
So Elliot was my driver, and that's why I sacked him.
He's gone through?
Yes.
Was that the reason why she resigned?
I don't think so, sir.
No wonder we don't have new clients coming over. Please, can I get... Let me have her number, please.
All right, sir. Zero. My phone is at my office, so I have it offhand. 080. 4:30.
So that's how it happened, sir. And permit me to say this, with all due respect, I think I am no longer comfortable with my wife working in your firm. For the singular reason that she keeps being sexually harassed by the managing director, Mr. Akpan.
No, Sylvia.
Sir.
Do you want your job back?
Sir, if I can be transferred to another branch, I don't mind.
No, I would rather want you here. I will transfer Akpan to the other branch, so that you can take over the new managing director of this firm.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir.
Elliot, what about you? What can you offer this firm?
So I have a degree in computer science, and I also have very, very strong skills in business and research.
Okay. Which means you can do a good business research?
Yes, sir. Perfectly well, 100%.
That goes well for me. You're a new business development officer of this very company.
Oh my God! Thank you so much! Thank you so much, sir!
That's good. Yeah, your wife has been so good here, and I would want both of you to be here. You understand?
God bless you so much, sir. Thank
Sorry.
You.
It's all right.
Thank
Sorry.
You for being a good person.
Sorry.
For you to climb up so high, I gave you wings so you could soar.
Oh, babe.
Come here.
I'm here.
Come here, darling.
Oh, babe. Somebody wants to eat somebody raw.
I know, right?
Okay, there he goes. Babe, I just kissed you and you know that, right?
Too, baby.
Yeah?
I love you.
I love you more.
Babe, I don't know why I lack sweet words to say this, but
this is why you're sounding like this.
Yeah, but I want to say this. I love you so much.
No.
Please. Please marry me, baby.
Why is so weird?
Come on, is that yes?
Yes.
Oh my God.
Oh,
baby.
Yes, we should
have
each other and carry burdens as one. Da da da.